boys and girls, it's me, Miss Anderson. So, we are studying plants this week. I've gave you books to read online on Epic Books. Go check out those books on plants. And one of the things about plants that I know, you have to put them in dirt. They have to go in the dirt. They have to get water and they have to get sunlight. But anytime I think about planting something, I think about putting it in dirt. Well, during this time that we've been at home, I have heard and seen, but not seen the end result, this stuff on Facebook and on the internet. And then my sister even told me that I can grow lettuce without putting it in the dirt. So I decided to have a green leaf lettuce experiment. So, and maybe you can do this with me at home. So this is what I've heard. All I need is sun, water, and the stalk, the very bottom part that we don't eat, of lettuce. So Miss Anderson doesn't eat iceberg lettuce. Miss Anderson's favorite kind of lettuce is iceberg lettuce. Not iceberg lettuce. I don't eat iceberg lettuce. My favorite kind of lettuce is green leaf lettuce. So, and that's what I happen to have in my fridge. But you'll see that in a minute. So we have to, I'm going to make an observation. When we go into my kitchen, you're going to see my observation, and I'm going to wait and show it to you when we get into the kitchen, because just wait and see. After I make my observation, I have to form some questions. Well, I already have the questions. Will it grow without dirt? If it does, why? How does it grow without dirt? That's my questions. The next thing we're going to do is we have to develop, or I have to develop, a hypothesis or make a prediction. That means I'm going to make a guess. I'm going to use everything I know. You know, I've heard about it online. People have told me, but I know that I need dirt, but some people say I don't. So I have to develop a hypothesis, and I've done that. I've made a prediction. Just based on everything I know, I think the stalk will grow a few leaves, maybe. I don't think it's going to look like something I go to the grocery store and get. I think maybe 3 or 4 leaves, maybe in a month. So this isn't going to happen overnight. This is going to happen, I say, in a month, maybe 3 or 4. I don't think it would look like the grocery store. So that's my prediction. That's my hypothesis. After you have your hypothesis, you have to try your experiment. I'm so excited. You're getting ready to go with me into my kitchen, and we are going to test my hypothesis. We're going to put my experiment, and hopefully you can do this experiment and put it into action. Like I said, I'm thinking a month, maybe 3 or 4 leaves in a month. I don't know. After that time, during the month, I'm going to gather and record my results. I made a little packet of paper here, and you can make your packet of any kind of paper. Look, touch my face. Don't do that. I even had paper that has stuff on the back. So it doesn't matter what kind of paper you're using. Just use any kind of paper. So I'm going to wait and show you that one in the kitchen. I'm going to show you that one. Step 5 is observe and record your results. And since this is going to take me a month, I have a picture already drawn of today, day 1. But I gave myself a few extra blank pages. And you may want to do that too, because I hope to draw and label and write the changes that I see. And then last but not least, there'll be number 6. I'm going to share the results and discuss the results with you. And hopefully, maybe if you do this experiment at home, you can share your results with me too. So I'm going to pause you. I'll be right back and we'll be in my kitchen. Hey guys. Hey, we're back in my kitchen. Well, we're in my kitchen. Welcome to my, have some dishes over there. So anyway, I have my green leaf lettuce here. And it's so gross, boys and girls. But, remember, right now my observations is it looks gross. Looks gross. Ugh. Oh, I just forgot it was in the fridge. Ugh. So, I put it in the water. Now, if you're doing this at home, be sure, be sure you have somebody at home, the grown-up, do this next part for you, okay? I am going to, you can't see it, cut it in the sink, because it's really gross. Okay. And there's still some gross parts on it. Y'all just don't know how hard I'm trying not to gag over this. Ah! Okay. So, okay, I have the stalk. It's got a little bit of brown on it. I don't know how that'll do. But I'm just going to leave it. Look, no, I picked it off. Okay, so here it is. Here is my little Tupperware. I'm going to put just a tiny bit of water in it, it says. Okay, so there we go. It's just the stalk, a tiny bit of water. Let me get my hands a quick wash. We'll come back to that in a minute. So, I have it in there. My next step is going to be, let's see, it's kind of exactly what I've labeled in my picture. I have a bowl, I have some water, and I have the stalk just sitting in that water, okay? The next thing I say, I need to set it in the sunlight and change, add water every 2 days, because that's what I read. So that's what I'm going to do. So I got to go find a sunny spot in my house. So we'll be right back. So I'm kind of shadowy right now. I have a really awkward place I have to get sunlight. Number one, my dog has a resting spot up here. And the most of the sunlight comes in this window. So I put a little chair here. Newton's checking it out. Here's my stalk. It's right in the window. So it's going to be getting sunlight. And we're going to have to keep Newton out of it. I also have another sweet little flower that someone gave me. And until it's safe to go to Lowe's and buy a flower pot, I need to put it there. But so there's my pretty flower. There's my green leaf lettuce stalk. And we got a month. Let's see what happens.